A team of researchers hope lab-grown brains from 550,000-year-old Neanderthals will be able to pilot the movements of a crab-like robot. The unbelievable experiment is using Neanderthal DNA to grow pea-sized brains masses, which are hooked up to robots to test the capabilities of the electrical signals detected within the tissue. Researchers from the University of California, San Diego, UCSD, School of Medicine are simultaneously growing brain tissue from human DNA to plug into the same crab-like machines. They hope the difference in robot movements achieved by the lab-grown brains of modern man and Neanderthals, who diverged from human beings around 550,000 to 765,000 years ago, will offer vital clues about the minds of our early ancestors. The lab-grown brains cannot achieve conscious thoughts or feelings, but can mimic the basic structure of a developed brain, and reveal key differences in how the nerve cells function. These mini-brains, known as organoids, are built using stem cells. "We're trying to recreate Neanderthal minds," said Dr. Alison Muwatri, who is leading the UCSD study. According to the researchers, studying organoids could reveal how our closest relatives differed from modern humans, and why humanity flourished while others became extinct. Dr. Muwatri has yet to publish any findings from the study. However, he revealed some early details about the work on Neanderthal organoids during a UCSD conference called Imagination and Human Evolution, which was held this month at the Salk Institute in Southern California. According to Dr. Muwatri, the team has managed to coax stem cells endowed with Neanderthal DNA into pea-sized masses that mimic the cortex, the outer layer of full-size brains. The first thing the researchers noticed about their newly grown Neanderthal brains was the shape, which was vastly different to those grown with typical human cells. While those grown from modern-day human DNA have a spherical shape, those developed from ancient man has a popcorn-like appearance, researchers claim. The Neanderthal neurons also make fewer synaptic connections than their modern counterparts, creating what resembles an abnormal neuronal network. This may have influenced the ability for the species to socialize, researchers have hinted. Several of these differences mirror the neuronal development of children with autism. "I don't want families to conclude that I'm comparing autistic kids to Neanderthals, but it's an important observation," Dr. Muwatri clarified during the Imagination and Human Evolution keynote. In modern humans, these types of changes are linked to defects in brain development that are needed for socialization. "If we believe that's one of our advantages over Neanderthals, it's relevant." Dr. Muwatri, who has a stepson with autism, is now wiring the organoids to robots that resemble crabs, hoping the electrical signals within the tiny balls of tissue will be able to control their movements. In the future, Dr. Muwatri wants to pit the Neanderthal brains against robots run by human organoids, to work out the differences in how the two minds learn. "Ultimately, we want to compare the Neanderthalized organoid with a human-controlled robot to test its ability to learn," Dr. Muwatri explained. "By doing this systematically, we will learn what are the genetic alterations that made us uniquely human and why they were positively selected." Upon learning about the researchers' plans to grow brain tissue from a 550,000-year-old ancestor, Dr. Todd Pruse of the Yerkes National Primate Research Center commented, "I'm a little envious. It's still a long haul to get from organoids to real brains, but if the technique can be developed enough to give us more information about normal tissue structure, then you've got something that's probably very useful," said Dr. Pruse, who studied the differences between humans and non-human primates, by comparing the differences in human brains and those of chimpanzees. The team at the University of California, San Diego is not the only group of researchers hoping to unlock clues about the differences between Homo sapiens and Neanderthals using organoids. Professor Svante Paabo, of the genetics department at the Max Planck Institute for Evolutionary Anthropology in Leipzig, Germany, is also working to create lab-grown Neanderthals' minds. Professor Paabo, who led the team that originally deciphered the Neanderthal genome by rescuing DNA from ancient bones, hopes to compare these organoids with those created using chimpanzee and modern human cells to determine the differences between the tissue mass. "There are lots of control experiments to do, and then I'm quite hopeful we'll overcome those doubts," Professor Paabo added. Earlier this year, a Japanese study recreated the structure of the typical Neanderthal brain for the first time, based on casts taken from fossil skulls. While the Neanderthal brains were found to be the same size as those of early human beings, the team found that the human brain had a larger cerebellum. This region is responsible for movement and coordination, and, according to the researchers, having more neurons in this region increases intelligence, attention, language processing and working and episodic memory, knowing or remembering, respectively. The findings suggest humans may have had a better shot at survival based on their ability to adapt.